My name is Melanie Parker, and I am Google's Chief Diversity Officer. I'd also like to introduce Malini, who's with us today. She's going to be providing ASL interpretation. It is great to be back for my third Google Cloud Next, this time for a look at nurturing and developing pathways to careers in tech. Today, I'd like to talk about how building a more diverse, inclusive culture, it's not just a competitive advantage for us at Google, but it's a responsibility as well. And as we get started, I want to let you know that the chat is open so you can engage with each other during this session. I want you to share thoughts, share where you're tuning in from, and we'll have a few of our folks on hand to join the conversation. We'll also get into what we're doing to widen pathways to tech careers at Google and across our industry. But first, I am so proud to say that Google is committed to making diversity, equity, and inclusion a part of everything we do, from how we build our products to how we build our workforce. I work hand in hand with our CEO, Sundar Pichai, and as part of our executive leadership team to bring our global DEI strategy to life. I also lead a passionate group of people whose work touches over 140,000 employees, stretches across nearly 60 countries, and helps millions of users who use our products and our platforms to run their households, their businesses, and their lives. And personally, I traveled down a very unlikely path to land this position. I'm a Black woman who grew up in a small town in North Carolina. My brother and I are proud alumni of HBCUs, and we were the first generation in our family to bring home a college degree, which I earned at a historically Black university, Hampton University. And unlike many of my peers, I didn't have anyone at home to explain the unwritten rules of corporate America or to help me navigate my career. Instead, I cobbled together a community of mentors, managers, and inspirational voices who helped me find my path. And that's an idea that I want to focus on today. Access, opportunity, and networking are critically important building blocks for a successful tech career. And that's especially true for folks like me who come from non-traditional backgrounds. Too many people from underrepresented communities find themselves confronting systemic inequalities, such as a lack of access to STEM education or access to high-speed internet that disrupt the pathway to tech careers. And for many who do navigate the pathway, we've seen how the weight of inequality can foster a sense of imposter syndrome once on the inside. It's that sinking feeling of doubt in our abilities and a feeling like a fraud, or that we don't belong, and that for some, it will linger for an entire career. Overcoming inequality and creating access to opportunity, including for our underrepresented talent, this is a top priority at Google. And we're taking decisive actions that create opportunities and steadily grow a workforce that reflects the world around us, to launch programs that support our communities globally, and to build products that better serve all of our users. In other words, to build for everyone, we need to weave diverse perspectives into every step of our design, engineering, and testing processes. And innovative ideas can come from everyone, from Googlers at the grassroots level, to engaged leaders, and to established diversity councils across the company. As an example, the Google Meet team worked on the light enhancement feature to better represent all skin tones in an inclusive way during our video calls. And through feedback from a diverse group of testers, the team was able to determine the right algorithm that better worked for all individuals across the skin tone spectrum. And this ensured that all video calls on Meet work well for everyone. And it was thanks to the collaborative work and questioning how to make products equitable for all. In another example, Google has internal teams to foster equity through technology, empowering our Black Plus community to innovate in the digital space by supporting their educational journey and helping them land roles in the tech industry. And we've also built external programs like Cloud Career Jumpstart It's a 12-week learning course for underrepresented students with computer science or information systems related majors or the relevant experience. And it offers free access to Google Cloud Associate Cloud Engineer training to prepare for the certification exam. We just published our diversity annual report, and I am excited to share that 2020 was our best year yet for hiring our Black Plus and Latinx Plus Googlers in the US. It was also our best year ever for hiring women in tech in the US and globally. In addition to hiring, we're also redoubling the focus on retaining Googlers from all underrepresented groups. And in full transparency, this is an area where we can and we must do better. Google depends on the best, brightest, and most diverse talent to not only help us solve today's challenges, but also to co-create solutions to tomorrow's problems. So we are building a lasting model of inclusion and belonging that helps all employees feel seen, connected, supported, and I hope, proud to be in service. Belonging is key to re-recruiting our workforce and acknowledging that not everyone experiences our culture the same way. Despite our best efforts, some team members are still feeling left out. There is work to do around building the culture that we've all been working so hard to co-create. Clearly, there's some other missing element. And as different as we are, we all have the same underlying need to feel valued, to feel like our contributions matter, to feel like we belong here. But being included isn't necessarily feeling like you belong. Being invited to the table is not the same as being welcome at the table and being valued like you belong. Personally, I've been inspired by the work of John Powell. John is an expert in the areas of civil rights and civil liberties, and he's a professor at Berkeley, and he leads the Institute of Othering and Belonging. And he looks at our primal need as humans to belong, and what fosters belonging, and what prevents it. And if you think about it, one of our primal fears is to be ostracized by our group. Aside from food and shelter, we need to belong. And we've evolved to ensure that we could maintain access to the resources that the group has. Many behaviors are dictated by this need to be accepted by others. But we're also guided by the fear of losing that very acceptance. And we've evolved to protect ourselves and our loved ones by determining who's in and who's out. And that comes down to identifying who's the least risk, those that we perceive most like us, and relegating those who aren't to the out crowd. And John calls that primal sorting of people into ins and outs, the cool kids versus the non-cool kids, as othering. And we don't necessarily do this consciously, but it is the behavior that stems from our unconscious bias, the subtle ways that we send messages, even virtually, of who's cool and who's not, who's valued, who's not. And that's why I believe that our work, it's not truly possible until we foster this sense of belonging. And as evolved humans, we have control over this. There are ways to check in with ourselves, noticing, are we turning inward, focusing on only who and what we know, versus turning outward to connect with and explicitly work with other groups and to seek ways to build common ground. And that would foster belonging and empathy. And this means that we need to co-create the workplace experience with our internal communities and redefine what it means to be a Googler by acknowledging where we can do better and by ensuring everyone feels like they belong, is positioned to do their best work, and can confidently bring their authentic, whole selves to work each day. And for underrepresented talent, this can make the difference between surviving and thriving in their career. And for those of us who are accustomed to muting parts of who we are, authenticity empowers us to do our very best work. Last summer, at the start of the global racial justice movement, I realized that I could no longer code switch or check parts of myself at the door in an act of self-preservation. To lead our deep work in racial equity and address the systemic and structural barriers, I need it to reconcile the most vulnerable parts of my own identity as a Black woman with the Black woman who happens to lead diversity at Google. And I know that this is the type of workplace environment that we strive to build. And with our collective, consistent efforts, that is what we'll do. We know that Google is most helpful when our products and our services reflect the needs of the people who are using them. To best serve our diverse global community of users, we need a more representative workforce. And while we're making progress, we know inequalities persist around access, opportunity, and networking for underrepresented talent. But through investments in creating pathways to STEM and with help from allies, we can broaden the talent pipeline, improve product design, and fulfill our mission of making DEI part of everything that we do. What does this look like? There's a real cognitive shift happening both inside and outside of Google around diversity, equity, and inclusion, and how we can best build for everyone. Externally, we're creating pathways to careers in tech as early as elementary and high school. We're expanding recruitment beyond the usual campuses like Stanford, Berkeley, Harvard, Yale, and doubling down on higher education institutions like Hispanic-serving institutions and historically Black colleges and universities serving underrepresented talent. Why? Because we know that 25% of Black graduates with STEM degrees, for example, they come from HBCUs, just like the one I attended. So this year, we began deepening and sustaining relationships with HBCUs. In June, we announced an historic, unrestricted $50 million grant that allows the presidents of these esteemed institutions to allocate resources in the manner that they see fit. We're also broadening career pathways to include a major Grow with Google career readiness investment that supports our Hispanic-serving institutions around the U.S. A significant economic opportunity grant for workforce development and digital skills training to thousands of Hispanics, and a career readiness program for Native American Indigenous serving institutions. And that's just a slice of the work that we're doing externally. And while I mentioned that 2020 was Google's biggest year in terms of hiring Black and Latinx talent in the U.S., we know that there's much more work to do inside of Google to retain and grow our talent. So broadly speaking, we've developed racial equity education for all Googlers and incorporated it into our new hire orientation. We've doubled the size of our retention and progression team, and we're on a path to triple this team by 2022. And this enables us to provide one-to-one support like coaching, networking, and internal mobility opportunities to help underrepresented Googlers grow and thrive. And we've rolled out an innovative onboarding program for our new Black Googlers so that they feel more supported right from the start. Our employees want to know that they can grow and thrive with us, and that's one reason why we're working to increase leadership representation among women, Black, and Latinx Googlers. We've introduced pathways to sponsorship for women in technical leadership roles. It's designed to accelerate their careers. We leverage partnerships with more than 24 community and professional organizations, and these partners offer professional development as well as networking opportunities for underrepresented Googlers. We also offer skills building initiatives like the Cloud Technical Residency Program, and with great intention, we've begun building a culture of belonging for all Googlers, as I described earlier. We've been very open about our successes and our challenges, and I invite you to explore this further at diversity.google.com. Now I know many of you are wondering, what can I do? So as you weigh your own strategies around engagement and retention, consider the role of allies in driving results. Allies can be leaders, managers, and peers. They support folks in marginalized groups to which they don't identify. Internally, we've created a number of pathways for allies that are seeking to support our underrepresented colleagues. These include an allyship pathway with group exercises for allies and resources for practicing or encouraging inclusive behaviors. We also have Google in Residence. Experienced Google software engineers teach introductory computer science classes on HBCU campuses. And we have faculty in residence. We have more than 50 faculty members from 30 HBCUs to design project-based, industry-informed content and to implement that content in their classrooms. Google has doubled in size in the past few years. We know our DEI commitments need to keep pace. Operating at this global scale, it heightens our sense of responsibility around DEI. And to paraphrase my colleague, Annie Jean Baptiste, there's no blueprint to doing this work perfectly. And while we don't have all the answers, we're eager to share what we've learned and also to learn from others. And in the spirit of learning leadership, I hope I'll be invited to share more discoveries in progress at Google Cloud Next 22. In closing, when our mission is to build for everyone, we have to work with everyone. So with help from allies and through smart investments in creating pathways to STEM careers, I am confident our talent pipeline will flourish. Real, meaningful change can take years, we know, but there's no need to wait for change to come. If you haven't already, please head over to the chat room and join the discussion. There, you can share some of your successes and your challenges around creating pathways to tech careers. This kind of dialogue can open minds and truly inspire change. I look forward to sharing more progress with you next year, and I'll bring others along who've been on this journey with us to share their experiences. Thank you for wrapping up day one of Google Cloud Next with me. It's been great sharing this time with you. We look forward to seeing you all here tomorrow for day two, which kicks off with our developer keynote. Until then, be sure to register at g.co/cloudnext for access to all of our content and join the conversation on social using hashtag Google Cloud Next. See you tomorrow.